The first one is this idea of symbolic consumption, which is all the symbolic meanings that come in around the brand and that we build into with our story and the lifestyle. We've got to think about register, make sure that voice is comfortable for the audience. It doesn't have to be identical, but it must be something that leaves the audience feeling comfortable and relaxed. And the third thing is this idea of congruence, whereby make sure that wherever it is your message appears, it fits with that bigger picture within where whatever the publication is that's being used. Symbolic consumption really relates to people's tastes, what Bourdieu called distinction. And in a way, the story is about as much as what I'm not prepared to be seen in, as is what I'm prepared to be seen in, or reading. Do I want to be seen with The Guardian in the tube, or do I want to be seen with The Telegraph? Because all these activities that we have send very important messages about ourselves to the groups that we want to send important messages to. I think that's the important thing to remember. For instance, a young person may wear clothes from a particular brand to convey to others that they're in touch with fashion trends. So that's why so much time and effort is invested by brands in building their narratives, building their stories, building the bigger picture around what their product's about, so that people immediately recognise, ah, that's part of where I belong, that's part of my style. Brands, of course, have to be careful how they tell their stories because, of course, they've got to relate to the particular audience they're appealing to. So that voice is really important. So what you've got to do is you've got to find some way of mapping the register you're using in terms of your tone of voice to the audience and what they expect to hear and that they're comfortable with. We know how hard brands work to develop and tell their stories and narratives, but there's got to be a neat fit between what the message is, what the product is, and where it's displayed. It's what we call congruence or fit. It's the sense that, for instance, Burberry, which is a totally upmarket fashion brand, would not be found, for instance, in something like a Daily Mail. It's really important that brands think really hard about all those surrounding bits of the message that they're sending out.